Welcome back to part 3 of my Excel 2007 overview guide. Let's now move on to look at the data tab on the ribbon. The Get External Data section contains a range of tools to help you import data into Excel 2007. You can import data from Microsoft Access, from tables on websites, from text files, and from other sources such as XML feeds, SQL, etc. You can also easily select from a range of data sources that you most commonly use. The Connection section allows you to manage and refresh any external data connections you may have on the spreadsheet. The Sort and Filter section enables you to manage your data within Excel 2007. You can sort selected data with the lowest values at the top, or vice versa, sort your data based on the criteria that you specify, apply a filter to your data, allowing you to select what data you want to be displayed from drop-down menus, clear or reapply filters or data sorts, as well as enabling you to apply more advanced filters to your data. The Data Tools section contains a range of tools that will help you manipulate your data. You can separate text contained in one cell into multiple columns, find and delete duplicate rows within your data, set limits on what data can be entered in cells, combine multiple groups of cells into one, as well as carrying out more advanced data analysis tasks. The Outline section enables you to manage how data is displayed in your spreadsheet. You can group and ungroup selected cells, display subtotals and totals for grouped cells, as well as commands to expand and collapse grouped data in your spreadsheet. The pop-up menu option in the Outline section allows you to tailor the position and look of your summary fields in your data. Let's now look at the Review tab. The Proofing section contains tools that enable you to proofread your spreadsheet. You can check for spelling errors, search for information online, view a thesaurus entry for the currently selected cells, as well as viewing a basic translation of the entry in the currently selected cell. The Comments section allows you to apply comments to cells. These act like electronic post-it notes for your spreadsheet. You can add a new comment in the currently selected cell or delete a comment. You can move between comments in the spreadsheet, as well as displaying all comments or just hiding the currently selected comment. The Changes section contains a range of tools that allow you to protect your spreadsheet from unauthorized editing. You can set up a password to protect your worksheet or the whole workbook. If you are using Excel 2007 on a networked PC, you can allow multiple users to edit the file. You can also restrict which cells other users can edit, as well as tracking changes made by others and protecting those tracked changes from being deleted. Now, let us have a look at the View tab. The Workbook Views section allows you to select from a range of different views of your spreadsheet. By default, Excel 2007 will use the normal view, but you can also select the page layout view, which gives you an idea of what the page will look like once printed, or the page break view, which shows you where page breaks are in your spreadsheet and allows you to click and drag these breaks. Custom view will allow you to set up the worksheet view and then save these custom options for use at a later date. If you want to view your worksheet without the ribbon, then click on Full Screen. Double-click on the title bar if you want the ribbon to reappear. The Show Hide section contains a range of tick box options that determine whether you want to view the ruler, grid lines, headings, etc. on the screen. The Zoom section enables you to set a predetermined or custom zoom level with which to view your worksheet. You can also quickly move back to 100% zoom, as well as zooming into your current selection. The Window section contains a range of tools relating to viewing worksheets in different ways. With New Window, you can open a new window in Excel 2007 that will contain another copy of your current workbook. Arrange All allows you to display all open workbooks on the screen at once, and Freeze Panes enables you to keep sections of your worksheet on the screen at all times, even when scrolling to other areas of the worksheet. You can view multiple sections of your worksheet with the split command. you can hide the current workbook with the hide command and bring it back with unhide. View side by side allows you to compare two worksheets next to each other. You can scroll both documents together with synchronized scrolling. You can also reset the worksheets to their previous position. You can save the current window layout by using the Save Workspace command, as well as switching between open workbooks. The Macros section allows you to create, run, or delete macros, usually used by more advanced users. When dealing with certain objects in Excel 2007, for example charts or inserting a shape or image, contextual menu tabs will appear on the ribbon that will be relevant to the task you are working on. These tabs will only appear while the object is selected, as you can see as I insert a shape into this worksheet. Once you deselect the shape, the contextual menu tab will disappear. That is the end of part 3 of my Excel overview guide. In part 4, we will look at the formula bar, the home menu, the quick access toolbar, and the status bar.